Hello, everyone. Welcome to Comic Artist Pro Secrets. I'm Ethan Van Sciver, your Uncle Ethan. Good to see you guys. Good to see you guys here in the chat. I didn't do a live stream yesterday. Look at my beard. Very busy. I'm very busy lately, guys. Very busy. I got a lot to do. I had to run around, first of all, in New Jersey in this time of the year. Pollen falls from the trees like you wouldn't believe. I washed my car twice this week, and I don't remember washing my car twice in the last year. Every morning you wake up with a fresh blanket of pollen all over everything. The pool has a layer of yellow over it. It's disgusting. I went out. I ran some errands. We have a little bit of help. Andrea's friend Michelle is here. She's doing some labels. She's doing labeling so that we can get your packages out to you quicker. I filled the car up. I had to make two trips to the post office. Filled up our SUV with posters. And then filled up the SUV also with comics. Lots and lots of eBay sales and things like that. It's been great. I mean, business is terrific. Thank you guys for making it so that we have to work so hard. That's something that, you know, cannot be overstated. Thank you guys very much for that. Big day today. I guess I'm going to go on the kill stream and talk about the success of CyberFrog 2. CyberFrog 2 was very, very successful. Very successful indeed. This is Wreck Planet, and every time I refresh it, it's a little bit more. We make a little bit more money on this campaign. We're in the in-demand period right now. So I'm just like, okay, let's push this. Maybe just $1,000 a day. If we could just make $1,000 a day, eventually, like in a month, we'll be at $900,000. And then it's just, it's a long climb to seven figures, but that's what I want to get to. I just want to say CyberFrog 2 made $1 million and actually just see that reflected on one single campaign. It would be so much fun to do that. So if you guys haven't backed Wreck Planet yet, please do. We're still doing good with the Executive Honeycomb boxes. We've sold 2,063 of them out of 2,500. So we've still got 437. God, I'm getting much, much better at mathematicalness. Mathematics. Getting much better at that. Then also, of course, CyberFrog Unforgettable Tales is also doing great. I think we're pretty close to, you know, if you follow the charts, people make these top 25 charts, top 50 charts of Indiegogo campaigns and crowdfunded campaigns altogether. And if you follow them, you'll see, we have passed Lone Star 2. With CyberFrog Unforgettable Tales, which is amazing. When I launched this campaign, Andrew's like, "You sure you want to do this?" I'm like, "Yeah, I think we'll make $100,000 on it. I think that's how much it's going to bring in." It did much better than that. We're almost at $180,000. Bully for us and bully for you. Let's see what's going on in the chat with you guys. I'm going to talk to you guys a little bit today, so feel free to talk back here. Let's see. A lot of mentions of Leroy. Oh, man, we could do that. I mean, look, the Preston Poulter thing, I guess, is going to be talked about tonight on the kill stream. Preston put up his own video. It's like 35-minute rebuttal about all of this stuff. And it's just, you know, it's like I watched a little bit of it to kind of gauge his, you know, the way he's going, and what he's doing about it is just kind of coming clean and being very matter of fact about his past. And what else are you going to do? I mean, at this point, my thing with Preston, is just to say, couldn't you just leave me alone? You know what I mean? Like this is the thing. Like, nobody wants to know this about you. Nobody wants to do this, but like, you are a stalker. You're a legitimate stalker. You're somebody who, sought my attention. You're somebody who demanded my time, and when you didn't get it, you decided to go about trying to destroy my life and my business. You're no victim. You're no victim. You've attracted the attention of Comicsgate, and Comicsgaters this is what they do. This is what they, you know, this is what the internet does. The internet did a big deep dive into my past, a big deep dive into everything about me, and came up with some embarrassing stuff. Came up with pictures of me crippling a horse. This is what the internet does, and it does it brutally and without regard for your feelings or what's fair. They make up their own reasons for why things are fair and unfair. They decide that they like you or don't like you, and the internet is almost its own entity. You just have to kind of cope with it. But I would say, you know, there's also an incredible amount of karma that comes around on the internet. An incredible amount of karma. I've seen it kind of happen. I've noticed that this is the case, and I can't help but just kind of say, boy, I wish you'd leave people alone. You know, I wish anti-comic skaters would just leave comic skate alone when people are having fun, and people are having fun with comic skate. So we can do that if you want. If you want to watch the if you want to watch any of this stuff, I guess we can do it. Let me see here. In the chat, we got a lot of great people. Horsegate. Oh my goodness. Yeah. That poor horse. I have no memory of that. I have absolutely no memory of that. Andrew was like, when did you ride a horse? I'm like, well, I had some, but I remember consistently being a wet blanket about it and being like, I'm not getting on the horse because I'm going to get thrown off the horse. I know it. No, I'll look silly on the horse anyway. I'm not going to do it. And I, you know, if you would ask me, have you ever gotten on a horse? I would have said, no, I don't think I did, but I guess I did. I guess I remember it now. I guess I did get up on the horse once or twice, and was photographed to my shame. And that's the internet. This, you know what that is? That is, that's Sheila Allen. She will find that stuff and make it. Oh God, that poor horse. Hail Caesar says Aiden Brennan. Hail Sheila says Jim Cox. Yeah, crippling a horse. What the hell, Ted Haxman? Yeah, like I own three horses, and you know, I'm not a light guy. I mean, I wouldn't say I'm obese. I wouldn't say that I'm extremely overweight. I wouldn't say that I'm morbidly obese, but I wouldn't get on a horse. You know, it's like I make a horse look like a camel when I sit on it. I shouldn't have done it. Let's see here. F. Preston, he would show no mercy. Well, I mean, that's, you know, that's the difference. I have mercy because I just don't want to fight with people. But again, you know, it's like we could go through this whole story. Preston Poulter is a guy let's look at this here for a minute. Let me just show you what the phenomenon of what's going on here. This Preston, why does your face always look so weird? This is the thing. This gentleman here, you know, he asked me to promote his books, which I kind of looked at and I went, well, you know, look, at a time when you're sort of promoting indie comics, I kind of tend to look at the artwork, and I just feel like, since I'm not going to read, don't send me a script and expect me to read it. I'm not going to do that. But if you have an indie book and the artwork looks really pretty good, then I might be agreeable about promoting your book. I might think that it meets my standards because, to me, honestly, comics, are mostly about the art. People have this conversation all the time, this debate about what's more important in comics, the art or the writing. Obviously, I think comics are a visual medium. And so a bad story with great art will do better. It's not going to last very long, but it will do better. If the art's good, you can get a mediocre writer you know, you'll get away with it, I think. Preston showed me one of his books, and I think he sent me one of his books and, you know, demanded that he be on my show and it sent me messages every single day. And I think I used to say, yeah, just stick with it. I mean, just keep, you know, I might not notice you right away, but eventually I will notice you. And if your book is good, I'll bring you on the show maybe, and I'll promote your book. Preston did talk to me, not talk to me. He sent me messages every single day, about his comic book persistently. aggressively saying, when today is a good time for me to be on your show. I'm glad. I wonder if Ethan liked the book. Well, let's see, Ethan, today, when today, what schedule with me when today you're going to promote my book on your show. I don't like that. I don't know what it is that bothers me. I don't like to feel like I'm being forced into doing something that I kind of do out of the kindness of my heart. I don't want to feel like, I don't want to feel pressured. I mean, that's the thing. I don't want to be, you know, I think that kind of pressure is very feminine. And I don't like to be dominated by feminine people. I don't like to have things forced on me in that way. I don't enjoy that. That's not my thing. So I ignored Preston, and I didn't even just ignore him. I just kind of, he's a non-factor. I'm really working on other things, and went on with my life. And Preston was so angry that he didn't get to come on my show that he just said, now I see how it really is. This is all about exploitation. You exploited and manipulated me. I did no such thing. Oh, you did. You exploited and manipulated me. And now Comicsgate doesn't deserve to live. I am going to destroy you. I'm going to destroy Comicsgate. And he set about to do just that. He set about to become somebody who is kind of somebody who tries to get into the works. What would you say? Why do I have a vocabulary right now? Somebody who tries to fuck things up for other people. Preston immediately started a show in which he would sort of lie about Comicsgate. He would spread conspiracies and gossip about Comicsgate. Some of it was true. Some of it wasn't true. It was that kind of a mixture. Truth, half-truth, lies together equals, you know, a very dangerous brew. Preston then would find, you know, situations where he could actually hurt other creators, you know, stealing Solo. He reported stealing Solo to both Disney and Harrison Ford's people. Why did you need to do that? Why did you need to do that? He's like, well, because it was a crime and that's what I did. Somebody has. Okay, well, it didn't need to be you. You don't need to be a narc and narc on your fellow creators. But Preston was very, very angry at having been ignored. Preston then went out of his way to report, to report Cecil's campaign to Indiegogo and try to get Cecil's campaign taken down because Cecil has a parody of Earthworm Jim. He tried to get Cecil's campaign taken down. At which point I thought maybe we should bring lawyers into this situation. You're messing with somebody's money. You're messing with hundreds of thousands of dollars of another creator's money and their dream. And you're doing it out of malice and spite. This is absolutely terrible. This guy went on then to continue to cause trouble and strife in the hearts and the feelings of comic skaters who were simply trying to create our own little platform here, our own little world. This guy went out of his way to decide to troll Comicsgate by pretending to trademark Comicsgate, the word Comicsgate, and then decide who gets to be a comic skater and who doesn't get to be a comic skater. The mainstream comic book media actually promoted this troll, actually promoted this whole thing. Now, of course, this is impossible. He simply applied for the trademark. He made, and it would have been denied. I'm sure it's been denied by now. But he made a little logo that made fun of Umbrella Guy and his mailbox situation. I don't know how any of this is constructive, and I don't know how any of this sells your comics. I'm not sure what this is now. So you've set yourself up full time. As an entity that is going to knock down people, creative people who are barely struggling to get to their feet and build their own businesses. That's what you've done. You're a trust fund kid. And as a trust fund kid, you've become a huge bully. Why? Why have you become a bully to little indie creators? Because I wouldn't let you on my show? That's very, very strange. I'm really glad that I didn't let you on my show. God kind of looks out for me. I do believe this. I do believe Jesus is on my side. Sorry. He's got to be because Jesus made me ignore you. when you were asking to be on my show, and therefore I don't have to explain to my audience why I promoted a guy who evidently spent a good portion of his time making femdom porno videos in which he is literally, you know, being cucked by black men who I guess ostensibly are being pleasured by his wife. I don't know what that's all about. Some disgusting pornography, frankly. And you know how I feel about pornography on this show. We try to avoid it. We try to avoid it. But in Preston's case, it's fascinating. It's absolutely fascinating. I will say I am not into this brand of kink at all. I don't get it. I guess I don't want to kink shame, except maybe I do for a second. Your humiliation and the humiliation that was evident, you know, and you, I hope you actually felt the humiliation that you were intended to feel in those videos that you made by a woman who didn't seem to care about you very much. Your humiliation, that's something you get to carry with you. You don't have to inflict that pain on everyone around you. That's not what a good person does. And by the way, that's not something that should win allies. And of course, you've attracted some of the worst allies in the world. You've attracted terrible people who lie, terrible people who spread lies and falsehoods and do nothing but try to cause distress in the lives of comic skaters who, again, aren't hurting anybody. I mean, at this point, Comic Skate has become a 100% positive movement full of people who just want to create their own comics, crowdfund their own comics, people who enjoy each other's company, people who love coming on live streams and saying hi to each other. We're not even bothering with the mainstream so much anymore. Every now and then, I think today I plan on reading an article that's pretty interesting from Bleeding Cool. But ComicsGate isn't what it used to be. ComicsGate is a 100% productive and creative movement, which gives people, creative people, hope. I'm proud to be a part of it. I don't like seeing it maligned every week. I don't like seeing it denigrated. I don't like seeing the people who are involved in ComicsGate being mistreated. I feel like they're my brothers and sisters, and at the very least, they're my customers. So when I see you experiencing extreme humiliation, as you were, it makes sense to me. Everything suddenly makes sense. I understand. I would be angry too, deep inside. Deep inside. I'd be angry too. You know, what's with the L's? How come there are a lot of L's? I just looked at the chat and everybody's typing L's. Anyway, this is going to be Preston. Here's a 36-minute video that Preston made that's completely unnecessary. I don't need to know why you made those videos. You know, the fact that those videos exist explain the one question that I did have, which is why you're harassing comic skaters. What is this? What is the L? Leroy, L for Leroy. Okay. Leroy is the black gentleman who, in one of the videos. The fact that those videos exist explain the only question I really had for you. I don't need to know why those videos exist. It's self-explanatory. Why are you so angry? Why are you so angry? You know, what did ComicsGate do to you? Except not bend over for you as you'd bent over for so many. I can't keep going in that direction. Why are you so angry at ComicsGate? ComicsGate did not insert a 10-inch dildo into your anus and make you suck it. We didn't do that to you. We didn't do that to you. We never would. We would never do that to you. That's not what ComicsGate does. ComicsGate eventually probably would have given you the chance. to come on this live stream or come on other people's live streams and get better promotion for your comics. This whole thing, your response to the doxing of your history of sexual deviance, that stuff's up on Pornhub. That stuff, you know, people found that. That's public. That's a big part of who you were and are, I guess. I feel sorry for you. Frankly, I feel very sorry for you. I saw a little bit of it. I saw images from it. Some of it was pretty funny. Most of it was very funny. But I feel very, very, very sorry for you. I mean, to the point where it's like I'm actually just sad, and I don't want to go into this and make fun of you. It's just that everything makes sense to me now. You know, it's like, you know, I have questions. I have questions like, why are people like this? You know, as I continue to go forward and produce Cyberfrog comics and continue with ComicsGate and make videos for you guys and succeed gloriously, I'm very happy. I mean, life has been better for me than it's ever been. I'm quite a happy fellow right now. My question is, why are people like this? And then the answers are incredible. I mean, they're absolutely incredible. And they come out and it's just like, Jesus, God Almighty, get this away from me. Like, get this away from me, please. It is. It is, the word is jolly. Then I am jolly, you're right. I'm getting jollier and jollier. The whole thing makes me physically ill. So what? Now we've got, you know, of course, Preston's friends are going to stand by him. Because their only use for him is that he's very, very good at making videos that cause people distress. Preston is good at making videos that make fun of ComicsGate. They need him to do that, I guess. They're hoping this is going to go away, but it isn't going to go away, Preston. JDA, Comic Book Hut, your lies don't mean anything. They aren't going to change what's going on here. They're not going to change the phenomenon of ComicsGate one bit. The good news is we don't actually have to burden ourselves with you. We can look at you as a cautionary tale and continue moving on. Anyone who wants to, in fact, this is the unfair kind of disadvantage of all this. You've got guys who are associated with Preston who may or may not be, being cuckolded on video, who may or may not be having large dildos inserted into them by women. I don't know. I don't know what these guys all get up to. Look, that's what comic skaters can say is, these are the people who are criticizing us. This is what we do. Here are our comic books. These are the people who don't like us. Very, very simple. It's a very simple bit of salesmanship. Our enemies take it coming and going on porno videos. God, it's so disgusting. And we're just sitting here making shiny frog comics. We're making comics called Jawbreakers. We're making comics called Another Case of the Littlest Umbrella, Vestige, Fregaboom's Black Flag, Pineapple Perception, Chrono Mechanics by R.T. Bear. This is the fruit of our labor. And these are the fruits that disapprove of us. I don't know what to say. Oh, my goodness sakes. That's pretty much what I want to say about Preston. I mean, tonight we're going to go into it. I'm going on the kill stream because I told, look, there are always these weirdos. There are a lot of my enemies who are like, just go on the kill stream. Just go. I dare you to go on the kill stream. I'm like, I'll go on the kill. And so I told Ethan Ralph, I said, I'll go on anytime you want. I'm not afraid of these people. Anytime you need me to go on, you want me to defend my position, you want me to talk to this guy or that guy who's got a problem with me, I don't lie. I don't have anything to hide. Anything that was embarrassing about my past has already been spilled out. All right. Everybody knows about my foreclosure. Everybody knows about my divorce. Today they're saying on the internet, by the way, my ex-wife, yeah, she was, you know, she was cheating on me with a parachute instructor before we got divorced. That's what causes divorces usually. Of course, he fell to his death. That's Jesus. and these guys were saying, I mean, the cruelty of these people, it's like at least Preston was having sex with his wife rather than someone else having sex with. I would rather be cheated on by my ex than be penetrated by her with a dildo. Cheat on me for the rest of time. I don't. That is the most insane thing in the world. Go try that with someone else. Let's get real now. That's the reality of what's going on the anti-Comicsgate side of things. Feel free. I'm not doing that stuff. That's sorry. If that's what it takes to keep a relationship together, get the fuck out of here. I have no mercy, no pity, none of that shit. I'm so sorry, man. This chat is getting dirty already. I didn't mean it to be. I wanted to talk about fifis and mercy and pity, but you got to be fucking kidding me. You got to be fucking kidding me with these people. Absolutely insane. All right. let me see here. Super chats. Da-na-na-na-na-na. Super chats. Hail Leroy says Christopher Arcella. Mark Collins says, I said on the rocks. That's right. Oh, God, that was from the video. The guy that was, he sent Preston to go put ice in his drink. Charlie's London official says, hey, EVS, love from London and love the hat. Thanks, Charlie's. Christopher Arcella says, EVS, everyone is a living nightmare. It is. The life is, everybody's crazy. Umbrella Guy says, Preston and pals are trying to deplatform Wenger. Well, I mean, look, here's what I would say, again, guys, about all this stuff. I would say stay out of trouble. Don't put yourselves in a position where you can be deplatformed. There's too much good stuff going on. You want to fight with these guys to the point where you could lose your ability to make a living? Why? It's not worth it. It's just not worth it. Everything's too good right now. Sheila Allen says, we sunk his battleship. No, you did, Sheila. You did. If the left could meme it was actually funny, they'd call you Ethan Mein Kampf. I think somebody actually did call me that. And I think that guy was not funny and he couldn't meme. I thought that was pretty weird. All right. Yeah, don't put yourself in a position where you can be pegged literally or metaphorically. Don't let these guys peg you. Look, don't pick fights with them. Don't say things to them. Don't make videos. Don't do any of this stuff where they can get your channel struck. Don't do it. It's just, you're going to regret it. Don't do it. Rise above it, guys. Rise above it, Comicsgate. Let's see. EVS should have a celebration stream. We should be talking about this. I am talking about this. I'm not celebrating it. This is the way the internet works, guys. You don't understand. You think this is going to actually hurt him with his own people? No. They're going to forget about this. None of them are going to internalize this. You think John Delarose really cares about this? He's not going to internalize this. And then, by the way, I don't want him to. I don't want him to ostracize Preston. I want Preston to still be the voice of and face and anus of anti-Comicsgate. I want this guy to be the receptacle of all of the anti-Comicsgate dildo memes. Not dildo memes. the dildo memes seem to be over. But this guy, he should be the face of anti-Comicsgate. It's wonderful. And if they actually disenfranchise him or walk away from him or show him disloyalty, that doesn't help us. That doesn't help Comicsgate. This guy's a billboard for what it means. I mean, every time we show these people for who they are, every time Renfamous shows her face or Vicky Verse, we get in a conversation with her and we leave her a stuttering mess. A Rumble Terrier, a nuisance. Anytime these guys actually, are confronted in any way. I mean, they do their own cause a tremendous disservice. I want them all to stay exactly where they are. I just would like it if at some point they stop bothering Comicsgate. But as long as somebody's going to bother Comicsgate, it might as well be them. As long as somebody is going to make a video called Last Week in Comicsgate, it should be somebody with the experience in front of a camera that Preston Poulter has. That's what I would like to see. Rick Rotman says, did Tenaple or Mike S. Miller tell Preston he's going to hell yet? See, that's a tricky one, Rick. It's technically heterosexual sex, even though it's degenerate. It's not for the purposes of procreation or to establish any kind of warm intimacy with your spouse, I wouldn't think. Not when there's another person involved. So technically, yeah, like even though it's heterosexual in a way, I guess, it isn't exactly biblical, is it? No, they have not. And I think Doug Tenaple is having is showing a display of Christian kind of kindness. That's where he's coming from right now. He's forgiving everyone. I don't really know. Well Hung and Dunk says, I'd hold your hair back, Ethan X. Thanks, Well Hung and Dunk. I think God has already held my hair back. But I I can't. Preston Poulter. Oh, for God's sake. All right. So let me get back to this. And F you, Well Hung and Dung. Even though, you know what? Yesterday you tweeted something about you pegging JDA for a stand-up guy. That shit was funny. Good for you. Congrats on the campaign. Here's to many more, says Grant D's Nuts. Raging Golden Eagle, thanks for the hot dog. Raging Golden Eagle, thanks for the peach. Eve said EEF. Says, let's see, Preston is an SJW that was trying to infiltrate Comicsgate. I don't know what he is. I don't know if he's an SJW. I mean, is he fighting for social justice? I don't know about that. All these guys are using SJW methods and techniques to deplatform Comicsgate, but that doesn't mean they're SJWs themselves. They're just using SJW language, talking points, techniques. I don't think they're fighting for what they perceive to be social equality or anything like that. I mean, let's get our terminology right. Social justice warriors are fighting for social justice. They use Alinsky tactics to get there. But they're, somebody like Preston or JDA, even though I saw, who did I see? Thomas Royloop. Who believes that webcomics are the future of the comic industry, I guess. That was the one time I debated him. That was his standpoint, his position. But I saw him talking in such a way that he sounded just like Tim Doyle. He was saying the same kinds of manipulative, using the same kinds of infuriating speech patterns that SJWs use. But it wasn't in service of social justice, so I don't know. All right. Uncle Ethan's pepperoni nipples. They're my nipples are pretty small. Huge Cyberfrog haul on eBay. Search Ethan Van Sciver Cyberfrog treasure trove. Don't miss out on vintage and modern collection. Only 4 days left. Rezakai says EBS changing on only promoting people with fulfilled projects. Lady Alchemy 33 will appreciate that. Martina looks at you with her raised judging eyebrow. What can I tell you? Seems like a good policy to me. Seems like a good policy. Tehaxman says, hey, EVS, can you shout out the book Colton Crux? It's a noir comic on Indiegogo, similar to Detective Dead, but with Lovecraftian vibes. I actually did shout it out on Twitter. I went through this. I went through Indiegogo, and I looked at all the books that were ending soon. And I looked at the ones. Most of them aren't Comicsgate, and some of them don't deserve to be funded. Like, you really... you really do kind of have to distinguish. Like, some of these books don't deserve to be funded, and they're just not quality books. And that's just Indiegogo comics. That isn't specifically Comicsgate books. But you can look at the ones that are good, and then you can determine if these guys might be Comicsgate or something like that. Colton Crux looked pretty good, and I did tweet it out. Let's talk about your nipples. Thanks. That's the first time I ever mentioned it, but you want me to talk about it even less, I'd be happy to do so. It's just the idea that they're pepperoni. That's Cecil. That's not me. That would be Cecil, his nipples. All right, let's see. Umbrella Guy says he put the mail in his mailbox. Umbrella Guy's spicy. Umbrella Guy's going to go, here's the thing. The difference between me and Umbrella Guy is Umbrella Guy's going to run with this stuff. I'm not going to. Umbrella Guy's got a lot of anger about, you know, Preston. A lot of anger, and he should. I mean, Preston Poulter, here's the thing. Preston Poulter and these guys trade in the private sex lives of some comic skaters. And I don't know if any of this stuff is ever true, but they spread rumors about Umbrella Guy and his marriage. And that stuff actually is private. You want to talk about, I mean, a lot of these guys are talking about revenge porn. Revenge porn is when, you know, there's an expectation of privacy. The two of you produce pornography, some pornographic content together, and then you break up or something like that, and then you release the pornography or the private porno stuff onto the internet with the intent or expectation that it's going to cause them distress. That's what revenge porn is. You know, so stuff that's on Pornhub is not revenge porn, even if it's embarrassing, if it's tremendously embarrassing. Look, Madonna did nude modeling before she became a big star. Penthouse bought the photographs and published them. It's not revenge porn. There was no expectation of privacy over that. And same thing with Preston Poulter. But actually digging into, you know, the private life of a comic skater and releasing that information is revenge porn. That's illegal. It's immoral, unethical, and illegal. It's nobody's business. That kind of thing is nobody's business, especially if you don't make it anyone's business. So Umbrella Guy, these guys have been spreading rumors about him for a long time. I don't know anything about Umbrella Guy's personal life. I don't want to know. It's none of my business. And these guys try to make it, you know, very, very public. It is illegal. So again, when they say things about revenge porn, that's, you know, they're engaged in that kind of a thing. They're actively looking for information that could embarrass comic skaters pornographically. Mike Oxmall says the big two don't track down amateur porn to embarrass their critics. Long live the big two. I'll always take Batman and Spider-Man over Cyberfrog. That's fair. I guess I don't track down amateur porn either. That's not something I do. Are you kidding me? I'm very busy doing Cyberfrog. The big two, you know, they don't have this weird situation that I seem to have with obsessive stalkers, specifically starting rumors about me personally and trying to undermine and destroy my life and the lives of other comic skaters. So I think that's an unfair thing. Although, you know, yeah, Batman and Spider-Man are good. Go read them. CJ Corella says Leroy is better than Mateo, is better than Donnie, is better than Preston. That's the new chart there. Scottish Nerd, thanks for the unicorn sticker. P. Callen says, I'd advise you just to tell Mr. P to go fudge himself, but he'd ask you to hold the camera. Mark Collins says, brings a whole new meaning to butthurt. How do you pronounce T-A-J-A-S? It's Texas, but it like Mexican. Preston's sorry attitude is a consequence of being given everything in the world except discipline. I think he did get some discipline. This is a different kind of discipline. AKA Spoiled Rotten. Charlie's London Official, thanks for $20, says, I don't care what someone does behind closed doors. I care. He called ladies in comic skate hoes. I've never been a hoe in my life, says Charlie's. I don't get why he didn't want to debate me about his book. Thought he liked being beat by girls. Charlie's. Yeah, this isn't a good guy. I don't know what to say. Tejas. That's how to pronounce T-E-J-A-S. Yeah, he went after everybody. He went after the women of Comic Skate too. Terrible. And Charlie's, who would be mean to Charlie's? Charlie's did nothing wrong. Let's see. Angelus Draven is a new member. Thank you for joining. Antonio Cardenia says, Hail Caesar, even Cecil is not that degenerate. I don't know that. I don't know what Cecil gets up to. I kind of think he's not, but who knows? Let's see. Mark C says, looks like someone has no control over one aspect of his life, looks to assert total control over another aspect of somebody else's life. This is about domination. Yeah, I was thinking about that too. I was thinking about like, is he, you know, that's one thing. Like, is that kind of humiliation something that he seeks to remedy by trying to dominate something else and assert himself in some way that's completely destructive and still very feminine? I don't know. Could be. Ask a psychologist or a therapist. Oh, that was the woman who was sticking the dildo in him. So don't ask a therapist. Lightkick One says, how close is Comicsgate to 10 million, Ethan? Looks like we're one quarter of the way there. We're at 2.6 million, I believe, right now. Dorby says, you did the worst thing imaginable to a guy like Preston. You ignored him. Keep doing that. Let's see. Well Hung and Dunk said, oh, I read that one. Eve says, Preston is a poster child of antis. Sucks for them. Goat Bacon, thanks for $5. Sebastian Anon says, sounds like a square peg in a round hole type of situation to me, EBS. Yeah. Indeed. Rhino says, I don't think cuckoldry is hetero since there's another man involved. Yeah, I don't know. I don't want to think about it. Peggy Poulter wasn't just watching. He was getting involved. Remember Leroy? Yeah. Again, this isn't stuff I want to think about too deeply. Comic Books and Cahoots says, Preston finds yet a new way to shame his family. Goat Bacon says, I've been humped. By the way, it kind of makes sense now. I will say this about that. Now, we said, what is wrong with Preston? I mean, you can see some fishy stuff about him, just like in his quirks and his bizarre, obsessive, compulsive, like, drive to hurt Comicsgate, which has nothing to do with him. Like, there's something wrong. Why is he a trust fund kid? He's 48 years old, I think. I thought he was in his 30s, but no, he's in his 40s. Why doesn't he have all his money? Like, why are his parents just doling out his inheritance or whatever to him? A little bit at a time. I think it's pretty clear now. Like, they got to know about this. How would his family not know about this? They got to know about this. Let's see. Goat Bacon says, I've been humming Steely Dan's Peg for almost 24 hours now. Get on the Caesar phone to Geek Chorus. Ninolu says, it's not revenge porn when PP talked proudly about it on your own podcast with his wife. Yeah. Yellow Flash says, Hail Leroy, champion of Comicsgate. Leroy seemed like a nice guy to me. He seemed actually like a very, very nice guy. Who knows? Let's see. Yeah. Sheila's bragging about it. Deadwood Dale's video yesterday was fucking hilarious. The audio clip he played, LMAO. I don't know how deeply I want to get into this. Deadwood Dale did have a video. Maybe that'll get played tonight on the kill stream. I don't know. Some of that. Leroy. Everybody loves Leroy. All right. So I don't know, guys. I'm sad by this whole thing. Honestly, it's depressing to me. This whole situation is extremely depressing. I don't know why it depresses me, but it does. I'm just kind of like sad about it. Yes, give me a second, guys. All right. Yeah, I'm just kind of sad about it. I'm just like, humanity is, there's a range of feelings. There's a range of humanity, a range. Some of it is kind of depressing. Cheap Whiskey says, Kirby says, cuck degeneracy has no place on Popstar. Camara says, Leroy and Stitch is my favorite movie. You guys just want to go with this, huh? Sebastian Anon says, PP is the next Tiger King. Let's see. Strictly Jake says, have Antonio on. We need his analysis. You know what? Antonio would do. Antonio would do a good job analyzing those videos. Send Leroy the link. Mr. Reborn says, because things have taken a dark turn. I think that's what it is. Yeah. It is dark, you know. It is sad. Let's see. Yeah. Preston, okay. All right. We're gonna move on for a little while. Well, if we want to return to this later, we will. But I'm seriously feel sick to my stomach. All right, Tony Isabella. Tony Isabella is a cracker. Tony Isabella is an SJW, and we don't talk about SJWs as much as we should anymore. They're still there. They're still pervasive in the comic book industry. Tony Isabella is very funny because he created Black Lightning, and I love these white guys who create black superheroes and name them Black. I love that shit. I just love it. He's Black Lightning. Well, Lightning isn't black. Lightning is like, you know, it's white, really. Yeah, but he's black. So he's, you know, his skin is black. So this is Black Lightning. Tony Isabella is a long-standing comic book writer. Look at this. Tony Isabella speaks out about DC Comics' treatment of Black Lightning. Sorry, buddy. You created him for DC. What are you going to do? DC can do whatever they want. Here's a good idea. Walk away. Here's a good idea. Don't get too attached. You know, here's a good idea. Don't have feelings. Don't catch feelings over the things you create for DC. This is good advice for Preston Poulter too, as he gets reamed in the ass by various women that he has, you know, professed to love. Tony Isabella is a longstanding comic book writer, editor, and journalist. Working in the comics industry since the 70s, including long stints in Marvel and DC Comics. He may be best known for creating the Black Lightning character with Trevor Von Eden. Trevor Von Eden, everyone. Yeah, I know. I'm sorry, guy from Red Bank. Let's see. Raijin, how long are you going to wait to tell me why your eyes change when you look at me? Tatsu, let me respect what is. Let my feelings be my own. I injure you. I don't want to. I'm not as certain as you think. This has got to be the worst. I don't understand any of that shit. But Isabella is not that keen on the character's current portrayal in the current Batman and the Outsider series. He has already expressed displeasure at the portrayal and use of Black Lightning, Jason Pierce, playing second fiddle to Batman in the comic. Well, what do you expect? It's called Batman and the Outsiders. It's Batman and the Outsiders. So he's an outsider and Batman is the leader. Even as he has his own TV series, Isabella has had a checkered relationship with DC Comics. Checkered. Checkers are black and white. Checkers are black and white. We'll make sure that it goes sour again. I can leave. You came here to say something, Jefferson, so say it. You knew I was with Shiva, didn't you?
I did. I will react to a choice a friend makes. I have no right to keep him from making that choice. I'm not what some people think I am.
But it seems like Black Lightning being portrayed as a divorced man with the possibility of other relationships does not sit well. It doesn't sit well. Did I freeze again? I froze during that performance? Come on. I thought that was good. Okay, let me read this again. I can leave.
You came here to say something, Jefferson, so say it.
You knew I was with Shiva, didn't you?
I did.
This is cuckery. Holy shit. This is, wow, amazing. This is cuckery. This is cuckery that we're experiencing here. Let me do this again. This is Leroy. This is Preston. I can leave.
You came here to say something, Leroy, so just say it.
What was her name? You knew I was with Miss Roulette, didn't you?
I did. I will react to a choice a friend makes. I have no right to keep him
or her, I would say her,
from making that choice. I'm not what some people think I am.
This is the worst writing in the entire world. These people, I mean, they make Batman talk like a social justice warrior. This is absolute cuckery. But it's okay. So in any case, Isabella posted to Facebook saying, with slight edits for language,
fuck DC Comics and everyone involved with their rancid Batman and the Outsiders book. Anyone who understands Jefferson Pierce knows Lynn is his one true love.
You got to be kidding me. Other comic creators replied with their own take on the situation. Joe Duffy said, "And this is why I shy away from reading anything on a work for hire gig, even after after even the greatest writer has replaced me. Before me and during my tenure is real. Afterwards, dicey fan fiction." Don McGregor, can you imagine this?
A funny thing. You gave a girl my character that I created in a work for hire arrangement another girlfriend. Lynn is his one true love.
Gotta be kidding me. Where's a picture of Tony Isabella? Is there one here? Hold on a second. This is too important. I gotta see Tony Isabella. Tony Isabella. Tony Isabella. And... All right, so this is holy shit. Why, dude? Why? Oh, my goodness sakes. All right. Tony is a bellend. That's what we're going to call him from here on out because we're not nice today. This is Tony.
There's lightning coming out of my hands.
Look, sir, you are too old to be concerned with such bullshit. You really are. You're too old for this. Oh, this is sad right here. Oh, you're too old for this nonsense. Do not worry about who your fictional character that you created in the 1970s is in love with in the Batman and the Outsiders book that you are no longer writing. This is absolutely insane. Let's see. Nick B says, answer my $5 question, you crotch lover. What? Crotch lover? Crotch lover? What is going on with you guys? You guys are spicy today. We'll get back to this in a second. I have to answer a $5 question. Nick B says, any part of you wishes that you created a different character other than the frog to be your main legacy creation? No. No, because look, I mean, here's the thing. I didn't have to pick up Cyber Frog again. I could do anything. I could do, Fearsome. I could do Rust Belt. I could do Anomaly. I could do any of the other characters that I've got lying around, any of the other projects I have. I will eventually. I think Cyberfrog's the coolest. Crotch could be male or female. No, you know what? When I think of crotch, I only think of female. You know? Because, here's the thing. Crotch sounds like there isn't a penis there. You know? I mean, I know that there that is, but crotch just means it almost just implies an area, and there's a vagina there. There's no penis there. So yes, I will say I am a crotch lover. I do love the women. I do love the ladies. One lady in particular. Crotch versus junk. Junk is women don't have junk. You can't say women have junk. They have they have a crotch. Men have junk because it's junk, it's hanging there. It's just junk. All right. Groin seems more male. Yeah, groin seems male because you can pull it. You pull your groin muscle and then you're messed up. All right. Can't read too much of the chat. Whenever I read too much of the chat, I get lost. I gotta stick with the agenda here. I gotta stick with the agenda. Tony Isabella. Can you imagine this? Other comics creators are saying, calm down, just don't read it. I mean, Joe Duffy, who is a woman, is saying, just look. Don't read. What are you reading these comics? Don't read these comics. Don McGregor replied saying, I have never read any Black Panther or Killraven books after I left. If you live with the characters day in, day out for years, I don't believe one can come to them with any objectivity and pain because you know what you intended to do and will never get to do. It's not fair to the other talent, and you don't find yourself on the grill when asked your thoughts on other creators' work. That's right. I've never read anyone else's Cyberfrog books, ever. I never will. Never will. Anyhow, I'll be involved in the books that I am doing at the time, and there isn't much spare time to invest in seeing what other people are doing. In other words, Don is saying, Tony, what the fuck is wrong with you that you're reading these books? You don't own Black Lightning. You don't own him. When I came to Panther's Quest, it was with the stipulation that I did not have to read anything that had been done in between Panther versus the Clan and the new series. In response, Tony says in all caps, "Fuck being fair to the other talent in this case." Holy shit, you're a loony dude. You're a lunatic, dude. Stop saying the F word all the time, Tony. Like, I can say it because, you know, it, when I say it, it's cool. When I say the F word, it's cool. When you say the F word, it's weird. It's weird because you look like this. Okay, grandpa. Okay, boomer. Like, literally boomer. Okay, boomer. You can't just say the F word when you look like this. You look like the "it's time to make the donuts" guy. You can't be just screaming. You can't be screaming profanity about things that don't mean anything. Who cares? Fuck being fair to the other talent. In this case, I created Black Lightning to stay for something. To stand for something, probably you meant. It stands for white people deciding what black heroes are. That's what it stands for. It stands for white supremacy, Tony Isabella. Your Black Lightning character stands for white supremacy. Tony Isabella, you are a white supremacist. And the reason I say that you're a white supremacist is because you are a white man who created a black superhero and you call him black. You actually put black in his name because that's what was in your little head. And then you think that as the white man, you get to have total and complete control over what the black man does. And that's just not the case. That is just not the case. Let go of your white supremacist urges. Let go of them. You know, just accept the fact that you look like the Stroman bread mascot. Only East Coasters will get that. And stop bothering black people. I would say stop bothering black people. He's a white savior, Ethan, says the anime slayer. Some people are saying move on to other news. No, I'm not going to. I'm going to stay with this. I have to read all this, guys. You think that this is like fun and games. It isn't fun and games. This is work. I'm doing real work right now. Fuck being fair to the other talent in this case. So nobody else is talented. Anyone else who's working on Black Panther or Black Lightning, I'm sorry. Blackity Black Black Man. Whatever the book is that some white guy created. They don't have any talent. I created Black Lightning to stand for something. If a TV series can honor and respect my core values for my creation, DC Comics can do the same. Kneel before me, DC Comics. I'm not going to say shit about the TV show because... You know, it's TV. I gotta kiss some TV ass. So I'm not gonna criticize the TV series because they'll just tell me to go fuck myself. But I feel like since I have a TV show, I can pretend that they're honoring and respecting my core values. And bully DC Comics, since they're about to be closed down by AT&T anyway, and I can virtue signal real loud. You know I love your Black Panther work. But you didn't create the character. There would still be a Black Panther without you. It wouldn't be as good as what you did with the character, but it would be there. There is only one person in the world without whom Black Lightning would not exist, and that's me! I don't care. Tony, I gotta be honest with you. Black Lightning's a completely superfluous character. Nobody cares. If Black Lightning disappeared tomorrow, nobody would give a shit. Like, Black Lightning is so boring. Nobody cares, dude. Oh my goodness, your entire life. If Tony Isabella wasn't here, there'd be no Black Lightning. Oh shit. Fuck. Oh my goodness. Well, I mean, that's the thing. That's like the butterfly effect. You know, butterfly flapped its wings somewhere in Korea. And because of that, a whole series of small events took place. Which caused this very strange, puggish man to be born, create a racist, a stereotype superhero, which he claims ownership of, even though he does not own it. DC Comics owns it. He did it as a work for hire. And now he gets to stomp around and say, my core values. That is the butterfly effect. Fuck that butterfly. Later, adding without the caps lock. And just to add this, I have commented and commented favorably to comics that followed my run on characters. I'm a critic and a reviewer. And that kind of fairness is part of my job. This new Batto would be a horrible book, Batman and the Outsiders, if it didn't fuck with my creation. Indeed. Why would it? This new Batto book would be a horrible book, even if it... Oh, indeed. I'm planning to write a favorable review of a comic written by someone I think is a jerk who's put forth an utterly false story of how I created Black Lightning. That's me! He's going to write a positive review of Cyberfrog. Yes! Yes! Thank you, Tony Isabella. I want to thank you, Tony Isabella, for creating Black Lightning. Thank you. Thank you for your positive review of Cyberfrog. Someone I think is a jerk, that's got to be me. How could that not be me? Right? Anytime anyone talks about somebody who's a jerk in comics, it's me. I'm the only one who isn't a jerk in comics. Everyone is a jerk in comics except for me. A jerk off. Bunch of sad sacks. Fender of Fire says, you look like the Strowman bread mascot. I do not. He does. Maybe a little I do. Andino Palacio says, if he says fat jerk, then it's Ethan. Thank you, Andino, for specificity.
I can, and if I decide to keep reviewing comics, will be objective.
Tom Belland. Look, we got two Bellands. Tom Belland told his own tale as a comic book reader. I used to love Gwen Stacy. She was beautiful. She loved Peter Parker, and I figured one day they'd get married. She was his perfect partner. When they killed her off, it devastated me. My mom let me mail a letter to Marvel Comics, and all it said was, fuck you, in red crayon. Jesus Christ. What is wrong with everyone? What a delightful child. Well, I got a nice letter, a nice fan letter from a child. Open it up, says, fuck you, in red crayon. You know, red rum. Fuck you. And they hooked Peter up with Mary Jane Watson. I thought it was stupid. And if they wanted him with a woman, why not Gwen? She was perfect. Years later, I get asked to write a Valentine's Day Spidey story. In the story, I decided to examine why he was with MJ. I wrote, fuck you, in red crayon and turned it into Marvel Comics. The end. Yeah, dickheads and bellends everywhere, Spike and Madness. Absolutely ridiculous. All right, what did he really say? Years later, I got to write a Valentine's Day Spidey story. In this story, I decided to examine why he was still with MJ. As I did, I actually convinced myself that Mary Jane is a much better fit than Gwen ever was. Gwen was a high school crush that always needed saving. Mary Jane was independent and fought back against her father and a stalker. There's a scene where Peter is in the shower going over the differences between her and Gwen. And that's actually the moment that flipped me to being an MJ fan. Sometimes what seems like a horrible decision can make sense later on if the stories are compelling enough. This entire industry is going away. This entire industry is going away. Stop talking about yourself. Stop talking about things. Start talking about me. Stop talking about yourself. Start talking about me. It's the least you could do. Get ahead of the curve. Start talking about me now before you're last to do so. It is funny. It is funny. All right, let me look at super chats here because I'm getting yelled at again. I'm getting yelled at. Like, read the super chats. Well, I'm trying to. You know, I mean, what do you guys? We got cuckoldry. We've got pegging. We've got racism, white supremacy. You know. But enough about JDA. We've also got super chats to read. All right. Pork bun versus roast beef sandwich. Classic showdown. I believe mainstream comics does go searching for porno, i.e. Joe Quesada playing the Paris Hilton tape. The guy who mailed a box of porn and Gerard Jones. Yeah, you're right about that. Wondering if I should reveal something here. Time's not right. We got to keep the focus on one thing. Now is not the time to talk about the early days of the internet, the porno mailing list, email list that I was a part of. That was a lot of people in comics were a part of, and it was pretty disgusting. We'll talk about that another time. Not tonight, because today, we will stick with what's going on right now. Yeah, I don't know how I got on that list. I don't know how I did. But I didn't know dogs and women could do that with each other. Got my free trading card in the mail. Thanks, Auntie A and Uncle E. You're welcome, Josh Boyer. You are welcome. Any part of you wishes that you... Oh, I read that part. Hail the soy voice, says Chris Stanley. Hail. Say Brav says, you are my favorite radio star. Thank you, Say Brav. And Black Lightning equals the Brooklyn Brawler in WWE, says Nick B. The Brooklyn Brawler. I don't know who that is. Yeah. Dude, the comic book industry is full of degeneracy, the likes of which we've only just begun to scratch the surface. it is foul. It is absolutely foul. And again, I mean, look, we're at the end of it. One day the book is going to be written. I will write my chapter in that book. Yes, really. Absolutely. Let me see here. Hey, Ethan, has anyone ever pointed out that your SJW impression voice is very similar to Lady Elaine character from Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood? Well, yes, somebody did do that before. And imagine Mr. Rogers himself putting on a soy boy voice. That was Lady Elaine, you know. So there's bound to be some difference there. Absolutely. imagine how bad Hollywood is. Yeah. Imagine Hollywood, but without the money. Imagine Hollywood, but everybody has no money. And so, you know, it is what it is. Yeah. Let me see. where's Zach? I don't know. Let me see where Zach is. I haven't talked to Zach today. Oh, last time I talked to Zach, I was like, dude, your campaign jumped forward big time. And I was so excited about it because it was hanging beneath six figures for a long time. And then suddenly, like, boom, it was like at 104. I said, what happened? What happened? How did you sell $10,000 worth of merch in like a day? Like, it was a day. And he said, yeah, I know. He's like, thank God that I found, look at this, sold out a bunch of copies of Lost Souls. He found 200 copies of Lost Souls. And he gave 100 copies to John Malin. And he put the other 100 copies up at $100 a piece, following my example, sold out in 3 hours. And I was like, damn, son. And I said, Zach, you know, this is why you have to keep stock of your old stories as you tell more stories going into the future. And he says, yes, I see that. This is why you have to slightly overprint. You know, the worst thing that you can do is that you could say, oh, I sold, let's just say this was it, 1,224 copies of Grand Bazaar. I'm going to print 1,300 copies. And then you barely have enough to cover replacements. And, you know, that's it. And then people go, well, wait, I didn't get a copy of Grand Bazaar in a year from now. And you go, well, I there aren't any more. You have to overprint. That's what this money is for. That's what this money's actually for, overprinting things. So congratulations to Zach. Looks like we're jumping up on the great big 110. We get $110,268. This is victory for Zach as he proceeds and pushes forward. Let me see here. What else do I have up here? Fragabooms, Pineapple Perception comic, which I'm not supposed to be promoting, but I like Dan. Everyone likes Dan. $112,648 for this book with 8 days left. He's got 1 week and 1 day left of the first, I guess, 30 days of this campaign. It'll be interesting to see where this gets. I'm going to project in 8 days, it gets to 150. I'm going to guess 150 in 8 days. And then from there, you know, he could relaunch another 30 days. And we could see this at 250. We could see this at 250, I think. It's quite possible. Support Dan Frege's Pineapple Perception, Black Flag. Over here, Chrono Mechanics. By our friend RT Bear. RT Bear has, launched this book. It looks funny. It looks cool. He can draw guitars, like, better than me. Only because I've never drawn a guitar. Honestly, if I tried, I could probably do it. I've never had to draw a guitar before in a comic, ever, I don't think. Maybe once or twice. Like, Impulse, probably. But this looks great. So, back RT Bear. He's a swell guy. He has fulfilled, and he's made everyone proud. Vestige number one is still doing terrific business. Every time I refresh it, look at this, $104,274. Nobody thought at the time that this campaign ended at $51,000 that they would be at Six Figures Young Lady, but now here they are at Six Figures Young Lady. This is awesome. Wiggle Wiggle says, "Hail Leroy." Tweeted Trash says, "They call me Mr. P." Drawing those strings is always the hardest part for a guitar. Apex says, "You have a guitar in your office, Caesar." Yeah, I have two. I got an acoustic and an electric that I can't even play. I can barely play them. I know one song, and it's "Daddy Can't Rape Us All." And I can't keep playing that song. That upsets too many people. I just wrote it on the spur of the moment, you know. It seems to have affected a lot of weirdos. Let's see. Another case for the Lit List umbrella. Your boy Tug has launched another book, the sequel to his first one, which came out. I read it the other day. This one's going to be in color. Andrea looked at it and she said, "Why is this in black and white?" I said, "Because it's a manga book." She said, "Well, it should be in color." All right. Well, it's in color now. No, the second book seems like it's going to be in color. This is my favorite cover. This looks really, really cool. I don't know why. I look at this and I go, from a distance, it looks like a photograph. It's a combination of really, really good, clever line work, brush work here, a nice angle on the drawing. It's very, very believable, and then great color work. But if you look at this from a distance, it does look like a painting by Alex Ross. I mean, damn, dude, damn. I've gotta admire that. We read the first few pages here of this book. It really is kind of coming together as a kind of daddy-daughter, thin man, sort of a mystery story. The Thin Man, the Case of the Thin Man. I don't know if anybody knows that stuff. Not a lot of boomers in here. Not as many 80-year-olds as I thought there would be in my audience. I thought there would be a few more 80-year-olds than there are. Crackhead Jeremy 33 says his daughter drew that. Yeah. His daughter drew this image, and he put it on the cover. That is the Umbrella Guy. And then we got monsters here, and the spider. I think everyone's really happy. A lot of people happy, feeling good. Back that Umbrella Guy's new book, another case for the Lit List Umbrella, and of course, Cyberfrog Unforgettable Tales 1 and 2. Is doing great business still. Thank you guys for supporting this. We are shipping out those Blacklight posters right now. We sent out 4 crates of them today. I don't know. I think it was 100. I think that equals 100. I think we sent out 100 posters today. Andrea told me not to say anything about it, but I don't know. I got to tell people. I got to brag about how cool Andrea is. She got 100 posters in the mail. Cyberfrog 2 Wrecked Planet is also still available. I'm thinking about doing another stretch goal for this, but as it stands, we're going to be adding the Salamandroid Ashcan. We're going to make that in color. I'm going to colorize the old 1990s Salamandroid Ashcan and redo it and throw it in everybody's order. So it seems like everybody did back it, but if you didn't back it, Would you please back Cyberfrog 2 Wrecked Planet? Thank you. I would appreciate it. I very much appreciate it. All right. You know, this is what I do. Let me see here. I prefer the Tall Man. Phantasm movie series is weird. Tall Man's creepy. Let's see. Cash Grab is better than Unforgettable Tales, says 7 of 9. Yeah, I forgot to promote Cash Grab. I got to get Cecil in here. I haven't talked to Cecil or Malin in a little while. Don't say stretch anymore, EVD. Why is it EVD? It's Ethan Van Sciver. It should be Ethan Van Sciver. EVS, thank you. Yeah, you corrected it. All right. I see a lot of people doing that. And I'm like, no, it's EVS. Bob, Bug with One Eye is King. Oh, look at that. You got me in a Lone Ranger hat riding a My Little Pony unicorn. That is degenerate. That is degenerate. Whatever you do, don't put Preston right here on the edge of that horn. Don't do that. I mean, it's like, Bob, all you do is just craziness. Thank you, Sheila. Appreciate that. Delia Smith says, diver. Yeah, like Ronnie James Dio, I'm a holy diver. Yeah, Preston has stretch goals. Like, not Ethan venereal disease. No, not at all. No way. It's disgusting. Rocket Ma'am is cucking with Leroy. Everyone likes. Don't support this guy. Do not support Bob Bug with One Eye is King. Don't support his, don't tell him he's doing good things. He's not doing good things. Bob is not doing good things, and he does not deserve your compassion or your praise. Stretch back holes. War campaign. Next time you do, when you do Vestige 2, not stretch goals, stretch back holes. I think that's probably a better thing. I think you'll get more results. If you call them stretch back holes. Oh, boy. All right, guys. Bob is going to pass Jabba. Yeah, Bob is doing better work than Jabba is lately. I think Jabba just got... Here's the thing. Like, if you get too much praise too early, you kind of become complacent. And Jabba the Cuck has become complacent. Andino Palacio is doing better work than him now. Bob Bug with One Eyes King is doing better work than Jabba. I go, ouch. Like, Andino makes me go, wow, oh, you know, like that. Like, I mean, I get dissed hard by those guys. And it's makes me very upset. But, you know, Jabba the Cuck is very friendly lately. Very friendly. John Carter says, EVS, why are you berating me? It's a great pick of you. No. Time to retire, coach. Yeah, this is it. Jabba is resting on his troll laurels and not doing a good job. He's getting high on his own supply. Better to burn out than to fade away, says Chris Stanley. Well, I mean, it's up to Jabba to decide where he wants to go. Adam C. says, has EVS stopped talking about nasty Yes. Yes, I did. I stopped talking about it. I talked about it in the beginning because that's what everybody wanted to hear me talk about. People are curious about my feelings about things, my thoughts. You know, they say, when is Ethan going to come and talk about cuckery? We need to hear what he has to say. Charlie's London says he still hates on me. LOL. Jabba the Cuck. Nathan Brennan Master says, hey, Ethan, Hexcraft Mechanics, Ultimate Control is still seeking lovers of old school bad girl comics to back these sexy, seductive, and dangerous ladies. Back Hexcraft Mechanics, Ultimate Control on Indiegogo today. Can we call Preston Captain Cornhole now? So Snark Condiam. You can call him whatever you want. I'm not stopping you. I think his life is sad. I think we've learned that his life is very, very sad. I'm a sucker for alliteration. Call them gape goals. So Stolen Falcon. Gape goals. Yeah, a lot of people have gape goals, you know. Yeah, people are saying Preston prolapse. Let's see. Jay Mills says, I know my poster is coming. Thanks, Uncle A. Hey, you got it. I don't know. I think some people got like notifications. Those girls are up there right now and they're packaging posters, putting the labels on them. And I think they figured out a way to like Indiegogo, you can like mark a package sent. And then I think the people get a notification, but we never knew how to do that before. I think they figured out how to do that now, which is good. Yeah. Jabba is kind, is nice to me. He bought my books. I don't know if Jabba bought my books. I have no idea. I don't know if he did. Probably not. Just Another Bastard. Thanks for $2. Appreciate that. Yeah, I don't know. You know, I never, I like a lot of alliteration. I never asked. I never said, Jabba, are you at least supporting me? Are you, even though you, you know, you diss me hardcore, are you at least supporting my comics? I never asked him that. I wouldn't be surprised if I did ask him that, if he did just laugh at me and say, no, Ethan, I don't back your shit. I'm not buying your comics. What are you fucking kidding me? At which point I would be crushed. I would be absolutely crushed. What is going on? Hold on a second. Why is Bleeding Cool doing this? I just had to look at Bleeding Cool to see what's what. Comics in general are becoming a lifestyle brand now. Nerd food. Make your breakfast magical with these pumpkin pancakes. Oh, it's a woman, right? Baltimore Lauren. Is that a girl? You can't let these girls do this. You can't let them do this. The first thing that they do is they come in and they make your hardcore gossip comic site into, you know, the Food Network. And the next thing they do is they peg you with a 10-inch black dildo. This is it's just one, step one, step two, step three. You can't let them do this. We're halfway to Halloween, and Disney Parks blog is celebrating all things spooky. We recently shared with you their adorable, fun Jack Skellington cookies, but now we're going to look at a recipe that's a little more traditionally fall. Now, pumpkin is out of season, but that doesn't mean you still can't enjoy pumpkin-flavored food. This recipe calls for canned pumpkin, which is found year-round. Pumpkin pancakes. This isn't what I expected to see on Bleeding Cool, but I got to be honest with you. This is what, ladies, take notes. This is what you need to buy at the store in order to make me pumpkin pancakes. Andrea. Hey, baby. I hear noise upstairs. I need to give her that recipe. Yeah, I need to give her that recipe so she can make me pumpkin pancakes tomorrow. She's upstairs. She's packing stuff. I can hear stuff, boxes being dropped on the floor, which means that I have to drive to the post office again. All right, let me look one more time. Let's do a last round of super chats. Hail the Soy Voice. Battlebrick Road is about 10 days in and will hit 30K soon, crushing my original Flying Fortress campaign. Hail Comics Gate, says Eric Weathers. That's Battlebrick Road. Mr. Schwagen says, imagine Mr. Rogers putting on lipstick and a dress, cleaning his shotgun Grandpa gave him, admiring his work in the mirror using that voice. Now that is spooky. You guys are good writers. You guys have good good thoughts. David H. says, EVS, did you see the Gail Simone Superman clip the Bleeding Fool posted to Twitter? Yeah, where she talks about Lois Lane being a bitch. Yeah, I did see that. That was funny. I don't know if it's worth showing people, you know, but Gail got embarrassed about it and she started blocking people who showed it to her and made fun of her about it. You know, Gail said, I don't know. In the 50s, Lois Lane started acting like a bitch and not someone that Superman would want to marry. Ladies, always avoid being a bitch so that you can be somebody that we would want to marry. I mean, your goal in life should be to get married. You know, girls who are scary don't find boys to marry. So don't be a scary bitch. You know, get married. You guys haven't seen it? I mean, I guess I could find it, you know, if you, let me see here. Strangers in the Night. Yeah, apparently, like, people were sharing this with Gail, and she no likey. She didn't like this at all. I don't know why. I mean, it's wasn't that bad. But people were saying, hey, look, Ethan and Gail have something in common. Why? I just, ew. Oh, God. Okay, we got Bleeding Fool's doing good work. I'm going to have to start referring to Bleeding Fool a little bit more to get information to do stuff. All right. Okay. All right, I found it. Okay, all right, I found it. So Gail Simone, this was back in 2006. Maybe they made a Superman documentary when that pedophile made a Superman movie. What was that pedophile's name? The guy who fucks little boys in swimming pools in Hollywood. I can't remember what that guy's name is. But anyway, he made a Superman film. And they made a whole documentary about it. You know, do you want to be in the documentary? Bryan Singer. That's the one. All right. Here's Gail. Look at Gail. Wait. Okay, here we go. Let's blow this up.
As comic book sales plummeted, DC eagerly brought in a new editor, Julius Schwartz. Schwartz encouraged a new generation of writers raised on Superman to update and re-examine the character.
Look at those writers. Intriguing,
if mixed, results.
Julius Schwartz was not a great Superman fan.
Under Schwartz's direction, Superman became more introspective, and Lois Lane received a feminist makeover.
We almost went too far the other way in that she just became a really bitchy, cynical female character that I don't think Superman would fall in love with.
Yeah, that's right. What's this? Have we found an area of common ground for Gail Simone and Ethan Van Sciver in DC's latest Superman documentary? Watch the full doc here. Magnificent. So Gail Salmon. Salmon's a fish. But that is what Gail's calling herself. Blocked, Bleeding Fool. Why would you block a news outlet like that? Why would you do that? Why would you block a news outlet? I would never block Bleeding Cool.
We almost went too far the other way in that she just became a really bitchy, cynical female character that I don't think Superman would fall in love with.
That's right. Superman is saving himself for the right girl. And that girl is not going to be a bitch. That girl's going to be a nice, feminine young lady. Gail is right. Feminism is not the answer to it. If you want to win Superman's heart, feminism is not the answer. You know? Wow, hold on one more second here. Please, I mean, you got to be kidding me with this. Bleeding Fool, I'm going to have to start making short videos again based on your website. Your articles are on point. Bleeding Fool's articles are on point. Hasbro bends the knee. Refers to Slave Leia as Hut Slayer in contest. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Somebody make a meme of this and have it say, me when she tells me to go hang out with my other hoes. This is me. This is me when she says, go hang out with your other hoes. Yeah. Right here. Normal people who don't mind the original term Slave Leia. Hold on a second. Let me blow this up. People like this image. Good job, Bleeding Fool. Why don't you go hang out with your other hoes? Okay, I will. I will, says Jabba the Hutt. Jabba the Cuck. This is not Jabba the Cuck at all. Normal people. I've often compared Disney Star Wars to a guy's poker game. More Preston Poulter jokes. You know what? It's never going to stop. They're going to be Preston Poulter jokes wherever we go. We might as well just lean into them. There's another one. You're drinking beer, smoking cigars, eating nachos, and having a great time. There's even a lady at the table who drinks and smokes as much as the guys do because she's one of the guys. But then comes in the host, overbearing, busybody wife, and changes the ashtray out for a vase with silk flowers. Then she changes the beer for wine coolers. Then she decides the kings and queens are too patriarchal and changes up the standard deck of cards for Parcheesi. Then She changes out the decadent nachos for bagel chips and hummus. Oh, Darth Maul hummus. God, that is disturbing. We got to stop this from happening. We got to stop this. Of course, the guests don't stick around to see all those changes. One by one, they leave to go someplace else where they can enjoy what they originally enjoyed. Even the drinking and smoking lady at the table has left because she likes nachos too. There's no possible way that Hasbro wouldn't understand this. Just recently, Hasbro unveiled new products that included no Disney trilogy merchandise. They know full well that the activists who clamor for changes in this material don't actually consume any of it by and large. We got through to them about this. We did. Yeah, yeah. And here they are yet complaining with the screeching idiocy of the feminists in the conference room. This iconic image had been known as Slave Leia for decades, even after Disney started to distance themselves from the problematic gold bikini. Now it's Hut Slayer Leia, according to Hasbro's website. Behold. Yes, Hut Slayer Leia. Hut Slayer. Slut. Hut Slayer. Hut Slayer. Yeah. Be sure to click the link. It's a competition Hasbro is running on what fans think the next Star Wars Black Series archive action figure should be. Something tells me they aren't expecting Hut Slayer to win this thing. We got to get Hut Slayer to win this thing. Can I click on this? We got to get Hut Slayer to win. I don't want any of these. I don't want any of these. I want Hut Slayer. Vote. I don't have a Hasbro Pulse account. Oh, this was a scam to get me to sign up for a Hasbro Pulse account. I don't want a Hasbro Pulse account. Son of a biatch. I do want a Hut Slayer action figure. But I don't want to sign up. Do you guys have any, do you guys have accounts? Yeah. Hut Slayer for the win. That was a scam, guys. Okay, that was a scam. But we skillfully sidestepped that scam. No problem. I'm so proud of everyone. I'm so proud of everyone. All right. So, by the way, in case you don't know, also, in the world of comics, at SJW's, Spider-Man's biatch, one of his biatches, the biatches of Spider-Man, a woman by the name of Black Cat. Has received an upgrade, a change, a redesign. Here it is. This is the way she looked before, and this is how she looks now. This was before, this is now. This is much more realistic, because this is the way she used to, yeah, this is real. This is the way she looked before. This is the way she looks now that she's been spayed, I guess. You know, when you get a cat spayed, they get fat. You know, they have nothing to live for except for eating. So this is her. And then this, look at, no chest either. No chesticles. A little bit like Squirrel Girl in the face. This is definitely an upgrade, guys. What do you think? Good? Yeah. Somebody said, I'm not going to buy Cyberfrog. I'm going to stick with Marvel and DC. Okay. All right. You do that. You stick with Marvel and DC. Some of us will stick with Cyberfrog and Heather Swain. Heather Swain is never going to look like this. She has to, Heather Swain is always on the run. She can't look like this. She's got to be athletic. She's not on the internet. She is not on the internet. All these characters now, they're all like in their personal lives, they're all doing what the bitches on the internet do. I'm running a Tinder site. No, not Tinder. It's Tinder gay men. What is Tinder? Tumblr. Yeah, that's better. I have a Tumblr site. I post on Tumblr. Fupa. Okay. By the way, I'm glad that like her name is Black Cat and she's not literally black. Just a something that, you know. Maybe she should be. Why isn't she? Do you want to upgrade Black Cat? Why couldn't she be black? Now, that's a good idea. That's the first thing that I would do. If I were going to do any ethnic swapping, I would make Black Cat into African American, you know. Declan Lyon says, I'll bet the new Black Cat has a camel toe you could park a bike in. Now that's, you know, that's not nice. All right, let me see. Can we call Preston Captain Cornhole now? You can call him whatever you want. Danny Rendon says, my husband is going to hate me for setting up a black light in our bedroom. Thanks, Ethan. You're welcome. You're welcome. Just Another Bastard, thanks for $2. Donuts One says, Jabba's laying low so no one looks for his videos. Zade Comics says, love seeing you on War Campaign last night. Hail, Uncle E. Tyrion Lancaster, thanks for £2. Snark to Con DM says, that noise upstairs is Andrea leaving you. She's not. Andrea! She's not leaving me, is she? Hold on, let me text her. Find out if she's leaving me. She didn't tell me she's going to leave me. I'll leave you a voice text. Oh, wait, that's audio. You don't want to do that. Like that. Okay. Andrea, are you upstairs leaving me? Question mark. Could you come downstairs and get this recipe for pumpkin pancakes and make me pumpkin pancakes at your earliest convenience, please? Thank you. Period. Dash. Your husband. Perfect. Okay. Yeah, she should. Sometimes you got to use text to communicate in this day and age. We'll see. Earliest convenience. Yeah, she's leaving me again. Punctuation is very key. Make sure. What? Your husband, not anymore. No, we're still married. We are still married, guys. You understand. All right, Uncle E, how would you suggest I get in touch with War Campaign? I got my package for Vestige, but all that was in it is bubble wrap. I hear her upstairs.
What?
Hi. They're saying that you're leaving me. Are you leaving me?
No, I'm doing homeschool.
Oh, you're up there doing homeschooling.
Yeah.
Well, Bleeding Cool published a pancake, a pumpkin pancake recipe. Wait, first, do you still love me?
I love you.
Okay. I love you too. Will you cook me pancakes? Pumpkins?
I don't have pumpkin.
Well, I think it comes in a can. Pumpkins come in a can. They were put there. You know who else comes in a can?
Ew.
All right, look, I'm sorry. It's Preston Poulter jokes all day long, babe. All day long. I'm sorry. It's not me. It's them. It's not me. If you could make pumpkin pancakes for me at some point, that would be good. Bleeding Cool has a good recipe.
Love you.
I love you too.
Going back to alligators.
Yes. Pumpkins come at Preston comes in a can. All right. Hey, Uncle E. Oh, I read that one. Wreck Planet, May 2021. Pumpkin pancakes now. I'll bet Black Cat. That was Chadwick. I'll bet Black Cat has a camel. Oh, I read that one. How is her chest flatter than her shading? Says John Moriarty. Terrible. Mr. Schwagen says, isn't the new Black Panther a woman? Yes. Number one Marvel fan says, hey, buddy. Just seen you're on. Hope all's well. All's well. You know, you guys scared me and said my wife was leaving me, but she's not. And she loves me. You heard her say it. Wondrous History of Classic Film. You should be proud of your accomplishments in the comic book world. I know we are. Thank you, Wondrous History of Classic Film. Antoine Dennison says, Andrea wouldn't leave before she got... Oh, her Corvette. You are 100% correct. She would not leave until she gets her Corvette. Yeah. I better make sure that I better stall on that Corvette. Gark777, Andrew's a sim. No, she's not. Not at all. Not at all. All right. You know, look, I can stall on the Corvette You know, I could just be like, it's not here yet. It's not. Corvettes aren't in season. So it's not here yet. Did you like the flowers I got you? Got you flowers. Yeah. I can stall. You know, you guys know that about me. Andrew's homeschooling Leroy. Oh, you son of a bitch. Let's see. Ethan, however, is a simp, but it's cute, so we allow it. I'm not a simp. I'm not a simp. I asked for pancakes. Simps don't get pancakes. You guys, look, Sheila Allen says, I believe Andrea exists. Thank you, Sheila. She believes you exist, too. She said, you're paying that Sheila girl a lot of attention. I'm like, I pay Jabba the Cuck a lot of attention. I barely pay Sheila any attention at all. Draco51683 says, you read my message about work campaign, but didn't respond because of pancakes. How would you get in touch? I would say talk to Wardong on Twitter. I would say look for the Wardong and see. Don't look for the Wardong. Look for Gat Hanzo. Gat Hanzo, if you're watching this right now, could you get in touch with Draco51683? Apparently, he didn't get his Vestige book. I don't have anything to do with that. That's their business. But yeah, they should be able to replace that for you pretty quick. Sounds like a pretty, you know, silly mistake. It happens sometimes. Charlie's London Official says, does Andrea want a lemon drizzle cake recipe? Lemon is my favorite flavor of anything. Like, I love lemonade. I love lemonade. yes, she does want that. All right. That's right. Don't worry, Queen Andrea. You're a goddess and a level of wifing to aspire for. That is correct. Good. All right. I love you all. But I'm going to go upstairs and I'm going to do stuff that you wouldn't believe. I'm gonna do amazing things. I'm going to go upstairs and do amazing things. You guys, I will see you tonight, I guess, on the kill stream. The kill stream is going to be unique. The kill stream is where all of the degenerate enemies of Comicsgate hang out. I like Ethan Ralph. He's always been nice to me. I think I like him. I don't know how he feels about me, but at least he's polite to me. I don't know if Andy Worski will be there. I don't know if Gator or Dame Pesos or all these other characters will be there. I don't really care. I'm just going there to have a good time. Yeah, there will be weirdos, I'm sure. Last time Rumble Terrier showed up, I hope they open the phone lines. Thomas Royal Loop, the Incel Brothers, they showed up. Can't believe I'm doing this again, dude. It's a trap, Ethan. Of course it is. I don't care. It's funny. It's funny. Who cares? Worski's a closet fan. But Andy Worski, he ordered, first of all, like, I got a message from him. I haven't seen any of his videos about me in a long time. But he ordered a copy off of eBay. And he was very polite. He was just like, I want to know where I backed your comic. Where is my comic? I said, you backed Unforgettable Tales. It's not coming out until July. Like, you know, we're making that book right now. You know, he's like, oh. He said, well, how do I get Blood Honey? And I said, well, here's a link on eBay. You could buy that right now. We'll ship it to you. He said, thank you, sir. I will. He bought a copy. He received it. And he told me he received it. And I haven't heard anything else from him. I was kind of hoping I'd get a review or something. I kind of felt like maybe he wanted to, you know, review the book and tear it apart or something like that. And that's why he wanted to. I'm all business. You know, you want to buy a copy of the book. I don't care what you do with it. Haven't heard. So. Stay back. Yeah, they didn't do any of the many more videos. I don't know. Like, it's I think these guys are trying to make me into an LOL cow. And the thing is, to the extent that I am an LOL cow, I am self-aware. So it's hard to make me into an LOL cow. And by the way, if they did successfully make me into an LOL cow, I would be thrilled. I would be a big part of that. I'd participate in all of that. That is what we do. Is it LOL or LOL cow? I don't know. It's so stupid. Fucking internet, man. You gotta love it. All right, so that's tonight. Is it 9:30? I think 9:30 Eastern Standard Time. I think I said I would be there, so I'll be there. We're gonna talk about the success of CyberFrog, the alleged success of CyberFrog. Zero people have backed it since I've been live streaming. Zero people have backed it. CyberFrog Unforgettable Tales. Did anyone back that? Zero people have backed CyberFrog Unforgettable Tales since I've been live streaming, but everyone is backing Fregaboom's Black Flag. And maybe that's okay. Maybe that's the way things should be. We want Dan Fraga's Black Flag to do well. Let's see. PP is an LOL Cal. I elevated him to infamy. Yeah, I think so. Ethan will fall asleep. That's a possibility because I haven't really seen 9:30 lately. I usually go to bed at like 8. I mean, lately, you know what? It's so nice outside. It's 6 o'clock. I start drinking. I'm out in the pool. I'm hanging out with Andrea and the girls. You know, I of course, I just fall asleep around 8:30, 8 o'clock, and wake up at like 2. Weird. You're making yourself an LOL cow by saying LOL cow, says Jude Vanalian. Everything I do goes wrong, Jude. Everything I do, I can't get anything right. Can't do it. Do you have dinner at 4 too? Yeah, I'm an old man. I love it. I have dinner at 4 p.m. at Denny's. Cecil is a bum. You're right about that. Where is Cecil? Is Cecil around? Cecil, are you? There he is. May all that don't back be pegged by Preston. Preston doesn't do any pegging. He's the peggy. Hold on. I want Cecil in here for a second. Cecil, if you're around, I don't know if you are, but, you know. I want to talk to you. I miss you. Cecil, I miss you. What is this here? Oh, all right. A lot of people are sending me weird stuff in my messages about the comic book industry. I don't really care. Like, when it comes to the comic book industry, I'm kind of over it. I'm kind of fully Comicsgate. I love Comicsgate. You know? All right. Let me see. Wow. Yeah, I've got a sculptor working on a CyberFrog statue. I cannot wait to see it. I cannot wait to see it. All right. Okay. Let me check one more thing. Cecil, I sent you the link. So could you come in here, please, so I can see you? I sent it to you on Twitter. Appreciate all that you do. All right. Good. Yeah, we're making statues, guys. By the way, I don't know if you know that, but we are making we're making lots of statues. What channel is the kill stream on? I don't know. Is it on D Live? Cumberbatch says, when is the villain's cover coming? I don't know. Villain's cover is coming, but I'm finishing up the Wrecked Planet Ashcan first. Because that's got to go to print. That's got to go to print in like a week. Here's Cecil. Hey, Cecil.
Oh, hello. Long time no see.
Yeah, you doing okay?
What's that?
Are you doing okay?
I'm doing fine, yeah.
What are you doing right now?
I'm doing good. I'm painting a room.
You're doing what?
I'm painting.
Oh, okay. I hear everything is pegging now. I thought you said pegging somebody, and it was disturbing. Almost everything that I've said tonight is a Preston Poulter joke, and it's an accident. It's like it's by accident, Cecil.
Yeah, pegging is all the rage. Preston really brought it back. It was kind of starting to lose momentum, but I think it's he's bringing it back for the summer. It's a hot new thing to do.
Are people going to be doing that this summer? Are they going to be allowing themselves to be reamed by their wives and friends?
I know we can only hope. I have said I'm against it. I feel like a man should never be in the birthing position.
That was disturbing, Cecil. I saw that and was like, what? I'm sorry, but you know, Deadwood Dale's audio, that sequence of audio.
Yeah, that was enough for me.
Should we play that sequence of audio?
Go ahead.
I don't know if we should, dude. I don't know if we should. Wait, I'm not going to show the visual, though, because there is a visual that he freeze frames on, and it is highly, highly, highly disturbing.
give a viewer warning for the sensitive and any youngsters.
Guys, if there are youngsters watching this right now, do not walk, turn off your computer. Those of you who are sensitive in any way, no visuals. It's just going to be the audio. It's just going to be the audio.
The audio is enough. I never had to look any further. I don't. I saw the thumbnail and the audio. And I was like, that's enough.
All right. So right now we have 1,579 people watching. We're about to play. This is bad. We're about to play the audio. If you want to go, you can. It looks like you just got like three more people in. I'm waiting for people to leave. If you want, everybody's like, no, don't do it. I'm leaving. Well, then leave. I'm waiting for you to go. I do not see the number dropping. I see it rising, Cecil.
It's a hit. I'm telling you.
Your watchers will drop by 50%, says Tasman. I don't see that happening. We just gained another couple of watchers. Okay. All right. Let's see. I'm going to unsub if you play it, says Jude Vanillion. Jude Vanillion, are you serious? Hold on a second. I have to negotiate with my viewers. No audio fool, says Vault Cobalt. LOL, it will rise. Losing viewers. Okay, I just lost 9 viewers. All right.
Oh, good. That makes me feel better, actually.
All right. We don't have to do it. We don't have to do it. We don't have to do it.
There should be a dropping out when you announce this. That's good. That restores my faith in humanity.
All right. Hold on. Let's see what people are saying here. Play piano accompaniment if you want people to leave. I can play piano accompaniment to the audio, honestly.
Can you make what he says into a song?
Yes, I could. viewer repellent, just beware flagging possibilities, says Sheila. All right, Cecil was the ex-boyfriend until of little Eddie Beale. I don't know what that means. Do it. and they say Ethan has no morals. Yes, I do. I want to make sure that you're all comfortable with this. I want to make sure you're all lying down. You know,
I feel like learning this information did take a little piece of my soul in the last day. Like, just brought an ugliness.
I have been depressed all day, Cecil. I got to be honest with you. Like, something is wrong with me. Like, ever since this happened, this came out, I've felt depressed. I felt a wave of nausea and depression over this. And I don't know why. I don't understand why. But it's just like, this is how low humanity can sink. Like, this
it
is
really
this
is. It's like you like to think it's like somewhere out there, and it's not somebody, even if it's one of your weirdo stalkers, you still think like they're not that weird.
They are. I mean, it's like they're because
they are.
We go, why are they like this? Why are they like this? We don't understand why they're like this. And then we find out, and it's like, of course, that's why they're like.
Were you truly shocked, though? I mean, when it was Preston, I honestly was not truly shocked.
I knew there was something like.
There's too much twitching, and there's so many warning signs. He's like a fucking alarm going off every time you look at him.
Yeah. It's like if you get backhold like that, I really, you know, and it's, yeah. It's not your natural thing. It's not what you like. That's going to change a man.
Snark the con DM for $1.99 says, Cecil, what's Preston's sexiest move? I think it's getting ice for the drinks is a pretty sexy move.
I'm not going to play it, Cecil. I'm not going to play it. I can't do that here, but it is funny.
No, maybe not. Maybe don't. I don't think I'm doing it on my channel, and my channel is way worse than
yours. Yeah. No, it's so basically, you know, it's Preston with his knees up around his ears, which is extremely disturbing.
Heels towards the ceiling.
Yeah. And he's going, and she's going, say you like it. And he's going, and she's going,
say you like it.
She's like, tell me you like it. I can't even use the words that she used.
You know what we should do? We should really make it. We should set it to music. It's a good duet. Like, it should be a guy part and a girl part, like Dolly and Kenny, with you know, a little, you know, a little a ballad, a duet. Do you like it? You know, but you have to have the right tune. But I think it could be a hit.
You think it could be a hit?
Yeah. When was the last good ballad, like a duet? When was the last good duet?
The last good duet was Islands in the Stream.
That's what I'm saying. This would overdue. And the lyrics are really, you know, they're heartfelt. You could tell he was, you know, it was coming from the heart, or at least somewhere on his body.
Yes. Yeah. Now, so like, see, so we don't even have to play the audio because Deadwood Dale actually subtitled it. So I'm going to
just play the subtitles without the audio. Oh, I think I cut out. Did I cut out or did you cut out? It could be me. Hello?
Hello, I'm back, I think. Okay, hold on. We got two Ethans. Got to remove them. Got to put Cecil back. Cecil?
Yes.
Okay, sorry. Yeah, my Google Chrome froze. Right when I was about to show people, you know.
Well, the ugliness.
Yeah, the ugliness of it all. All right, so I'm back. Can you guys see me? Can you guys see me and hear me, everybody in the chat? I hope so. Okay, people. Okay, here we go. Cecil, now we have to do it. We're being pushed back again.
We have to do it?
Yeah, we have to do it. All right, so this is oh, wait. I lost it already. Hold on a second. I had it just right where I wanted it to be. Okay, so this is audio. Say... this is... Cecil. know, we don't have to play the audio. We could just show the
lyrics.
Yeah,
show the lyrics of the song. This right. could be on a karaoke in 20 years.
Don't make me angry. Okay, don't make me angry. See, that's the thing. Say it. You know, I know you're feeling strongly, but say it. Say it.
All right. I know you're feeling strongly.
And here is Preston.
I like it when you. Couldn't you hear Dolly and Kenny singing this?
I like what you said in this. You go, this guy tried to get my Indiegogo taken down. The thing I wished on him, he already willingly did 9 years ago. You gotta be kidding me, sweetheart.
This oh my guy was god born. When I said he was born to lose, I mean, I've born didn't his mutant power is to lose. He is born to fucking lose.
Yes, he is. He is born to lose in a ridiculous and humiliating way. Andrea just came down with the pumpkin pancakes. Now,
wow.
Yeah. You understand? Damn.
There's no way you're making it to 9:30. You're gonna go into a sugar coma right now and wake up at 2 a.m.
I didn't know she was doing that. She actually went up. Now, I said, would you consider making me pancakes, pumpkin pancakes? Now, this is the difference between what's going on in my home and what was going on in that home. you know, very in my home. Yeah. Very different scenarios wherein, you know, I'm not being told that I will make my wife angry if I do not say that I like being gaped by her. And I just mentioned that I would like extravagant pumpkin pancakes because I saw them on Bleeding Cool. And Andrea goes upstairs. She finds pumpkin in the cupboard, canned pumpkin. She finds the recipe on Bleeding Cool. Completely not set up. This is just something I was not expecting it. And while we're talking about pure degeneracy, Andrea comes down with the pancakes.
See? Yeah, something wholesome to cut through the evil. It was nice. It was a good break.
Yeah.
It's a palate cleanser.
Now, Cecil, that is what being a man is all about, in my opinion.
Yeah, I would say you've got the right idea.
You listen, play the audio, you coward. I'm not playing the audio. All you had to do was see it. When you hear the audio, it sounds like it sounds like a sniveling little man who is who's having some trouble.
Maybe Geek Chorus can get a woman and do it. He could do the turn it into a country song, a duet.
I don't know why Geek Chorus couldn't do it. Say you like it. Don't make me angry. Say you like it when I fill your little hole with my.
I like it. I like the way
That's the man's part. Wait, let me get the lyrics up again. So here's the thing: if we're gonna do this, we gotta get the lyrics right. And by the way, you know the lyrics are already written, so. Cecil, did you just leave on accident? Cecil, come on back. Cecil, come back. I can't write this song alone. Okay, there he is. Hold on. All right, Cecil.
I kicked myself by accident.
Okay. Well, don't do that because we have to write a song here. So let's go back and let's look at the lyrics. All right, so back here. This is a... Okay, make him stage one, make him vulnerable. God damn it, Cecil. This is infuriating. For someone like me, this is infuriating.
Okay.
All right, let me see if there's a line before. Yes. I can't show any images. Okay.
This is your part.
I'm gonna I'm gonna your little hole. All right. This is you.
Yes.
Wait. I know you like it. Say it. Say it. Say you like me to your tiny little hole. Your little tiny hole. I got to get that right. Your little tiny hole. Why does this exist in the world? Why does this exist? Oh my God. Oh, I can't. You know, I like to hear it. Say it. I don't know how this goes with music.
I know, I like to hear it. Say it.
You know what? Dude, honestly,
I said to you years ago, I'm like, the weird, you know, there's nothing. You know, coming from different business worlds, I'm like, you know, there's nothing like this comic book world you've been in. There's nothing that compares to it anywhere. It's the weirdest fucking thing. Everybody's a fucking nut job.
No, everyone's crazy. And then everybody's making excuses for other people's craziness, which is what's going on today.
Who do you think?
Yeah, Hutt, John Delarose. Oh my goodness!
They're all in on it. They're all doing the same thing. You want to know the common thread?
Yeah, that was a mouthful of autumn. That was fantastic, baby. Great pancakes if you're watching. That was fantastic. All right. Okay, so we got the lyrics now. You know I like to hear it. You know I like to hear you say it. Let me see here. Say that you like me to your little tiny hole. Say that you like it. Say that you like me to your little tiny hole. Say that you like it. Say that you like me to your little tiny hole. Hope Ava's teachers aren't listening upstairs. I'm
you haven't worked. You're not having work done on the house, right? There's not like a plumber in.
The plumber's coming over tomorrow. We gotta get this done today. Say that you like me. Say that you like me to your little tiny. Oh, say that you like it. You know I like to hear it with my great big. Okay, here we go. I know you're feeling strongly, but say it, say it, say it. I know you're feeling strongly, but say it, say it, you little bitch. Yeah, Cecil, sing along with me. I know you're feeling strongly, but say it, say it, say it, say it. I know you're feeling strongly, but say it.
Say it, say it, you little bitch.
Say that you like me to your little tiny.
We got a hit.
This is a good song. We're putting it together. Don't make me angry. Don't make me angry. That's when it gets dark. Dun, 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 dun. There's a dark section. Don't make me angry. All right, here we go. I know you're feeling strongly, but say it, say it. Say it. I know you're feeling strongly, but say it.
I like when you fuck my tiny hole with your big cock.
You know what? It's kind of a Meatloaf song. The more. I would do anything for love.
By the dashboard light.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, honestly, it is kind of Meatloaf. We need to get a female voice, and really.
I can't take it. I can't take it no more.
Oh God! What is that noise, Cecil? What's going on with you?
Oh, can you hear that?
Yeah, a lot of noise and feedback.
The little stand on my phone. I'm playing with my tiny little hole.
This deserves a real professional hazard by Richard Markstop Productions. It's sort of impressive. We could do it.
Yeah, this could be the theme of the upcoming Top Gun movie.
Can the song be added as a stretch goal? Pun intended, says Jimmy Owens. Perfect.
We need some studio time.
Yeah, like there are a lot of people who have studios who can make good music. Now, I would say this to you. I don't know what you guys are doing. Why not record this song? There are a lot of talented people.
The lyrics are out there, and as far as I could tell, they're public domain.
It's definitely, well, let's be careful. We know that Preston owns the trademark to a lot of things. I think we own the trademark to that ass, though, right now. So maybe we can go ahead and make a song of this quickly. Johnny Dollar said Cecil should sing like Edith Bunker. Daniel Parker says, now I think we know what Meatloaf wouldn't do for love. I don't think he would do that for love.
No, he won't do that. He would do anything, but.
Yeah. Michael Beacon says, Poulter doesn't get pancakes. He gets cream pies.
I've seen a lot of descriptions of a lot of stuff. I have not. I'm like, there's a lot more braver souls out there than me that have been going combing through that video.
I'm not looking at any of it. I saw some of the stuff on War Campaign, and that was enough for me.
Oh my God, they must be going crazy.
Andreas Jacobson says, Ethan, you're killing me. Everyone at work is wondering why I'm laughing like a psycho. Cecil, your audio is garbage here. My ears are bleeding at the moment, says Raptor Jesus.
Let me go upstairs. I'll get better at Wi-Fi.
Yeah.
There were family members around, so I went to a secluded part of the house.
7 of 9 says, why do I watch you people? Because you love us. That's why we love you too. You know,
this is the only place on YouTube for this kind of entertainment.
Yeah. Billy Jacob says, Cecil, did you barf in the ice bucket I got you?
No, I didn't barf. Thank you, by the way, for that ice bucket. But no, I went in a garbage can. I wouldn't throw up in an ice bucket.
Yeah. This could be the grossest episode of Hail Salad, says Snarkticon DM. I don't know how they could make that into, you know.
Well, I heard my audio was bad, so maybe he can't use it.
Yeah. It's exactly what Meatloaf was talking about.
Yeah, he won't do that. He'd do anything. Yeah, who else is going to do this kind of show? You think Gail Simone's going to sing about this?
I kind of expected that's all she was going to do, but that's not what she did. You know, so we have to step up and create content, you know, that fills this hole. You know, that's what we have to do.
That's what I would call that should be the name of the song, Tiny Hole in My Heart.
Yeah, people said the singing was okay. All right, thank you, Raptor Jesus. So audio wise, the singing was okay. It wasn't quality singing, but at least it came through all right. Hello, yeah, Dan.
I'm on a phone. Oh, there's Dan. What's up, Dan?
You know, when Dan joined Comicsgate, I don't think he was expecting this, you know.
He jumped in with both feet. We were on a stream with me, Malin, and Anna last night on Anna's. Was that this morning? I don't know. I sleep so weird now. I don't even know what fucking day it is.
I know, me neither. I saw the date today. It's the 18th today. And I was like, wow. Yeah, we could call this song. A lot of people are having different ideas. I appreciate all the creativity. Total Eclipse of the Ass. I'm not gonna survive this. I'm gonna die. I really am. No. I gotta make it through. This is beneath us.
The worst thing. I would say the average maturity of the average 40-something in Comicsgate is about fourth grade, fifth grade tops. This is just too much for us to handle.
It's like a bounty. It's like, what do we do with this? It's, you know what it is? It's like we're 16-year-olds and dad got us a Lamborghini and we're like, we're afraid to floor it. You know, it's like, dude, we could do so much cool shit with this, but I don't know why.
You got to stay in the driveway.
Yeah, it's like, I don't know why we're so lucky. I don't want to get in the car. Mark C says, would this be an episode of Hail Salad or Toss Salad? I don't know. Call the song Wormhole, says EEF. I think Total Eclipse of the Ass, you know. I think that one nails it right there. I mean, I don't, you know. Let's see. Dan Fraggy says, just topped off with Adam Friended. What did I miss? Nothing. I never mature past 13, says Eric Hutfels. I didn't either, really. I never want to either. They go, Ethan's a giant 15-year-old. I'm like, 12-year-old? You know, it's like, give me a break. When I was 12, it was awesome.
Yeah. I would have thought Total Eclipse of the Ass was just as funny. right now as I did when I was in sophomore year.
Life is good. Getting pumpkin pancakes, laughing at Preston Poulter. That's four P's. Pumpkin pancakes, Preston Poulter, penetrated, pegged, prolapsed.
Did you see somebody renamed him Prest?
Pressed in Poulter.
No, pressed in Pooper.
Oh, guys. Oh, my God. Thank God. Hail, Comicscape. Hail. Oh.
Hail, Preston Pooper.
People go, Ethan thinks Jesus is doing this. Ethan thinks Jesus is doing this for him. Who else would be doing this? This is what God is. This is what God does.
If God is with you, who could stand against you?
Nobody. Every day. This is
a smiting if I've ever seen it.
Well, I use that word. I said, God is smiting my enemies. And I'm telling you, those enemies got very upset. Oh, Ethan thinks God is doing this. Yes, I do. You might as well take up skydiving, Cecil. This is every day I'm delighted. Every day.
Would you, if you had a library like this laying around on the internet, would you start fights with anyone?
I mean, it's like, yeah, like why? Yeah.
If you had this shit laying around, would you even, I'd be like a mouse.
Yeah. Like, why would you do this? Why would you do this? It's so weird. And why would you do it like, particularly in one of these movements here where like everything comes out about you, like, you know, you are going to be exposed. The bad guys will find out everything about you. You know, we're going to find out everything about the bad guys. Why would you do this? Crazy.
Especially since he put it on. It's not like.
But you know what's interesting? Cecil, here's the thing. Like, Anti-Comics Kid is quick to point out that, you know, when they attacked you, when Preston went and tried to get your Indiegogo taken down, and I don't know if you remember that, but that was a big thing. I said, this might get legal. And I said, I remember saying, okay, I need Comicscape to do something. I need Comicscapers to take a deep dive into Preston Poulter. All of his communications, all of his public email shit, all of his social media, anything pertaining to, or perhaps pertaining to this situation with Cecil, we need to compile. So if he watches videos, watch what he's saying, we need all of that stuff. Well, Preston like took that to mean that I was doing a deep dive on him personally, like his whole life. But if that, and they kept saying, Ethan does that. He's doxing people. If that were true, how the fuck did I miss this, Cecil? I mean, you know, a bored housewife found this in 2 seconds. I mean, that right there is proof of the integrity and goodness of Comicscape. That we didn't find this before. We're not looking
for stuff. Plus, I'm sure there are people out there that have his address and everything. No one's giving it out. No, you know what I mean? If people have it, they're not putting it out there. They're not putting out his phone numbers. They're not putting out, like, he's not getting ducks. This is shit with his face that he posted online.
Yeah, but, like, we're not even, like, if we had known about this a year ago, don't you think, like, we would have put this out? We didn't know because we don't do that. Like, that's not what we do. That's what they do. That's not what we do. I'd like to congratulate. I'm feeling, you know what, Cecil, the best thing is we get to make fun of him being pegged and be holier than thou. That is the best situation. We get to make ass jokes and be, you know, self-righteous about it. What do you think?
Yeah, no, he is self-righteous.
No, we get to be.
Oh, well, he's kind of self-righteous too. Yeah, well, of course, we're better. We are holier than thou. We're smart. I mean, he's lowered the bar for holiness so well that I feel very holy next to him.
Yeah, yeah. It's like we didn't do anything wrong. We did everything right. And we found out that you get fucked up the ass by women with dildos. So, you know.
And I heard he takes care of the equipment afterwards, that he does clean it off.
With his mouth, yeah. That is a...
Now, you know.
It's got to be. What are you going to do? You got their germs. You got to clean it up.
Got to clean them up.
And the worst thing about it is, Cecil, it's the, I think he, I, this is what kind of disturbed me today, because she's sitting there and he's putting his mouth on it. Okay. You see what I'm saying? She's on the couch and he's on his knees in front of her. There's eye to eye contact throughout. And this kept me up at night. Yeah, it's so disturbing. The eye-to-eye contact is so goddamn disturbing. Like, you're doing that and you're meeting eyes while you're doing... even now, it makes me...
Listen, he was already the creepiest motherfucker I ever knew before I saw this video. he's so far off the charts like that. I'm like, I don't even know how to label him. He was already the weirdest, like just something skin crawling about him, weird. And that was before I knew any of this.
And now it's like,
now that I know it, I can't even process. Like, I don't know what level he's leveled up. He's over 9,000.
He is over 9,000. John Delarose is not going to leave his man behind. John Rose never leaves his friends behind. Never.
Well, I always assume that birds of a feather, and that this might be the bond between the gang. You know, whether it's the Hut, Doug, John, it might be like the thing they bonded on. You always wonder, like, how did all these guys become friends? Like, there's not. And then you never know. I think this might be the, like I said, birds of a feather. This might be the thing they're into.
Yeah.
And they kind of bonded over.
A lot of people are saying, how do I find these videos? Look up Mr. P on Pornhub. I'm not saying you should do that. Don't do that. Look up Mistress Roulette or Mr. P on Pornhub. They have several videos. I don't recommend them. But that is...
There's one with Leroy.
Yeah.
That was like a special guest when like Lionel Jefferson drops by.
Lionel Jefferson drops by. Or yeah, William. Alfred Ortiz. He says William, the videos.
Michael, Lionel's here from next door. How's your mother, Lionel?
This is the main video. By the way, Preston's videos about me break about 1,600 views sometimes. This video in which he's being sodomized.
How many views?
About 1,600 when he talks about me. But when he gets sodomized, this is over 1 million views. It's called How to Break Your Man. So you can search How to Break Your Man on Pornhub and you'll find. See, that's embarrassing. It's embarrassing that when you're talking about comics, you get 1,600 views. But, you know, when you're being defiled, when you're being rammed from behind. With a 10-inch marital aid.
Right. You see, this is a man who found his calling. He found something he was good at, a success, and he walked away from it. You know, God gives us gifts.
Seven-figure bitch, literally, yeah.
And, you know, God gives us each a gift, and he's turning his back on the gift that God gave him, which is to lay on the bed like a baby with his feet in the air. He's good at it, you know. A million views is nothing to sneeze at. So he really turned his back on God and went into comics. He should go back to what he was made to do, what he was built to do.
I think a lot of people are going to metaphorically make him do just that, Cecil.
I'm saying, would it be a shame if Mozart went into like bricklaying?
Mm-hmm.
God gave you a gift. Use it, Preston. You get a million views.
Yeah,
you're changing lives.
Exactly. Like, you have a gift. You're a dildo magician. You make 9-inch penises disappear. You know, be proud of that.
I couldn't do it. I tried.
Yeah. Red Gaze did a remix. Good. Everybody apparently Anna made a video about this. I didn't know Anna made a video about it.
She did?
That's what they're saying. I think Anna made a video.
No.
I can't picture her doing that.
No. We couldn't even talk about that. Like me, Cat and Chokeout came on her channel the other night, and like she had to delete that stream instantly from what the conversation went through. And it wasn't even, and that was before Preston. He was talking about his time in Thailand. She's like, all right, this video's gone.
Yeah, I don't see it.
Hold on. Okay. Oh, it's on Twitter. Oh, animate a video on Twitter. Okay. Yeah, don't put that on your channel.
What did Anna say on Twitter?
I don't know. I didn't see it. I've been painting.
Oh.
She just made, I guess she made a video for Twitter, but not for her channel.
Yeah. Well, I don't know what to say, Cecil. You know.
What can you say? A picture's worth 1,000 words.
And I don't want to show it, so I feel stifled. You know, I mean, that's the problem.
I think we got something here with the song. If you want to, when I'm back at my studio, if you want to record a proper duet.
Yeah, get my guitar out. Thank you. In the meantime, let me monetize Preston's backhole. You know, the Cyberfrog 2 Wreck Planet. It's in demand now. We're going slowly here, but I mean, this is nice. We just jumped to 867. I'd love to see this get to 870, Cecil. Maybe it will tonight. I mean, I don't know how the kill stream is. I don't know if kill stream exactly.
By the way, people are saying pull up Anna's Twitter thing. They said it's really funny that she went off crazy.
She went off crazy about on Twitter about this?
About Preston. She made a video.
Is Anna that Star Wars girl on Twitter too?
Yeah. What do you mean? She's in the Jack Show DM with you.
Yeah, I know, but she's already in there, so I don't think about what her Twitter name is.
That's that Star Wars girl.
Okay, hold on. I got it. Yeah, this is gonna be rough here, so to speak. Not that rough, not as rough as Preston's used to. Some good art there. Scrolling down. Hoes be crazy, karma's a bitch, says, okay, here we go.
Hoes be crazy, everyone. So, this weirdo dude named Preston, that likes to draw lesbians making out from World War II, I think, he did, a video all about me. But, guess what? I'm, like, barely mentioning the video.
Why is it like this?
Let's go look at this weirdo that likes to just talk shit about everyone. Look at his teeny-weeny little YouTube channel. All of his videos are him just talking shit about me, about my friends, and, just complaining. But guess what? Guess what, weirdo? Karma's a fucking bitch. Karma's a bitch. You're porn. You with the strap on. Oh my god, this is the face of the man that makes fun of you. The dude that gets fucked in the ass with a strap on, that holds the dick toy while she gives another man head.
All right.
And you try to be the
All right.
Whoa. Whoa. I was not expecting that.
Wow, Anna.
Anna's a pit bull.
I mean, I just didn't, you know, it was weird to hear that from the chipmunks.
Alvin!
Anna's like, well, look at this picture here. Look at this. Ah! And I'm sure there's far more.
Dave, look at this, Dave.
Evidently, there's a video of Preston in a gimp suit getting kicked in the balls over and over again. I do kind of want to see that.
I heard about that too.
You know.
Oh my god. Yeah. It just gets better. Like people just keep posting like just clips of like just saying what they're describing what they're seeing. Like there's one of them in a gimp suit. There's one where he's cleaning a thing with his mouth. There's one where he's eating something. I don't want to say. It's just one after another. This guy's a vile, disgusting fucking human being. He's so disgusting.
I mean, yeah, it's like sometimes I feel sorry for him. And then I think like this guy actively decided that he was going to try to destroy my business. Hey, this is how I feed my family. Pumpkin pancakes. Tried to take down Cecil's Indiegogo campaign out of spite. Tried to get Jeff from World Class Bullshitters sued. You know, it's like, there's no reason to do any of that. Like, this guy's malicious. Like, he's a, you know, you would think he's a masochist, but I think he's switched and he's trying to be a sadist. Let's make him a masochist again. I like that better. Snarkticon DM says, this is going to make for a fantastic Jack show.
He's a true masochist because even when he tries to be a sadist, he ends up fucking himself. Like, he's just, you know what I mean? He's going to lose. He's the type of guy, if he was swinging the paddle at someone, he'd hit himself in the balls by accident. This is what it is.
Sheila's right. Like, oh my God, Sheila's right. He was begging to be discovered. Yet, no, like, this guy's into being ritually humiliated in the worst possible ways. So how do you get people to do this to you? How do you do that? How do you get everyone to humiliate you on a massive scale? You have to piss everyone off in a completely unnecessary way. And then those people are going to eventually find out about your porno. What a fucking weirdo. Cecil, am I right about this?
I think she said that. I think there's something to that. Like, he in a way wanted to be punished and found out and humiliated. Like, his thing is to be humiliated. That's his kink. So in a way, yeah. I think we kind of figured it out now.
Preston's ex-wife was drilling for Jenkum, says Snarkticon DM. Snorum11ARU says, stayed home to get my sink fixed and got the best live stream in months. Thanks, Ethan, Cecil, and Anna. Our pleasure. We live to serve. Johnny Dollar says, Eddie Haskell died today. Aww.
Oh, no.
I met him a few times. He's a nice guy.
Who was the other one who died? Not Lambchop. Who died the other day?
Fred Willard.
Fred Willard. That one hurt me. I really like that guy.
Yeah. 7 of 9 says, yes, Ethan, you're correct. Yeah, I think that's exactly right. Like, so here was Preston's whole thing. Like, why did he do all this? Because Preston is sexually attracted to being humiliated. So Preston has all this stuff out there that's easily discoverable. So what he did was he picked a fight with the internet. He picked a fight with Comicsgate, and he was cruel. I mean, Preston was cruel. And unnecessarily so to Comicsgate, saying a lot of weird shit that was none of his business. And so eventually this stuff comes out and then everyone's talking about him taking it in the ass. Everyone is. Now it's a big humiliation and he likes it. And then what he gets to do is he gets to go on and make a 38-minute video on his own channel talking about his own humiliation. For people to go, oh, that this is brave of you. This is one big con game. This guy's a sick fuck. He's a con artist and a sick fuck and a pervert who just wants to be emasculated in front of people. Like, that is his kink. How weird.
It's stranger than fiction. If I couldn't have made this shit up 2 days ago.
We just run into these characters. Charlie's London's official said one of his trolls came after me saying my project will fail. And it sounds terrible because I super chatted you a joke. Anna stuck you for me, stuck up for on Twitter. Anna stuck you for me on Twitter. Yeah, that's interesting. Okay. So he's into being found out as well. Yeah. I think that's true.
If you get off on being humiliated, I mean, you throw this stuff out there and just, you know, hope it comes back and you got, I mean, this is massive humiliation. This is like, but I have to believe that on some level he wanted it. There's no way I'd be a mouse if there was this video out there. I mean, I wouldn't be starting fucking fights.
You wouldn't want people to know unless you'd want people to know. So that exactly. Is. Okay, we figured him out now. Christ almighty. Ethan's correct? Oh. No, Sheila's correct. Ethan taking credit for someone else's theory.
No, Sheila said it.
Sheila led to it. She said he was begging to be found out. You know, that was that's correct. But that's this is who this guy is. Cecil knows all about humiliation, says our guest.
Yeah, but not that kind.
No, not this kind.
There's certain truth to that.
All right, I'm going to go for now because I got to do another big live stream tonight at 9:30 on the Kill Stream. Cecil, thank you for coming on. I enjoyed having you.
Absolutely. I'll be watching tonight.
All right, cool, everyone. We'll see you tonight on the Kill Stream. Thanks. Bye.
Dude, bye.